Okay, let's start with today's topic, that is mass transfer without convection. Now, in this, the very first case which we'll discuss today is diffusion in the rectangular coordinates. Then we'll consider diffusion in the circular coordinates and then diffusion in the spherical coordinates. We'll be considering three different cases of diffusion. So, the first one is diffusion through rectangular coordinates. Okay. Now, in this, what we consider, you know, a transfer of species by diffusion through a slightly tapered slab. Now, the slab which is given to you is something like this. It is a slightly tapered slab. This is the point where the origin starts, and let's say this is the thickness delta z. The taper angle is small, it's a slightly tapered, so tapered angle is small. Mass transfer is considered in 1D, that is in the z direction. The mass transfer is in z direction, and that too in 1D. Now, the molar flux of component A can be written as NaZ, which is minus C dAB dXA by dZ. Now, the negative sign over here signifies that the position that the positive z direction is in the direction of the decreasing concentration. That is, it signifies the decreasing concentration in the positive z direction. That is, as the z direction increases towards left to right, the concentration is in the negative direction. It's decreasing basically. So, if you apply the overall balance over this finite thickness delta x, so over this finite difference delta x, we are going to apply the balance over here. So, that will be A into NaZ at Z minus A into NaZ at Z plus delta Z is equal to zero. Now, why we have kept A? That's because the cross-sectional area is a variable and it's dependent upon the Z term. So, it's a, we have taken as A. Now, if we divide this entire equation by delta Z and take the limit delta Z approaches zero, so what we are left with is, we are left with d a n is it by dz equal to zero. Obviously, there is a negative over here, negative goes on the other side. So this means the flux times the area. Now, the flux into the area is basically the molar rate, molar transfer rate, which is NA. So A into NA is your molar rate, which is basically the constant according to this equation. Now, if you substitute the value of A, NaZ, that is this in this equation. So obviously A is the A cross-sectional area in the direction of the flow. It's the cross-sectional area in the direction of mass flux. Now, if you substitute the value of NaZ over here and integrate it, it ends up as dAB into dXA equal to minus Na. Now Na can be divided by A, so it's a constant, it can be taken out. So dz over A, and where it varies from 0 to z, the sigma solution is 0 to x A. Right? So this is what gets upon this thing integrated. Now over here we can take area. Now this area is a function of z, since area is varying in dz direction. So I've written A into Az, that is area which is variable in dz direction. Now the boundary conditions over here are at z equal to 0, let's say the x A is x naught, and at z equal to L, we have x A as x A L. Now, depending upon certain particular things over in this thing, that the expression can be variable. Now, let's see those conditions. So, let's write over here the constants, the molar transfer rate, and we have the concentration distribution or the concentration profile. Now, if there is nothing, there is no term as constant, none. If there is nothing constant, then this expression can be written as dAb into dxA over 0 to z dz over az. That is this molar rate, molar transfer rate can be integrated. That is, it can be modified in this, and it can be written as this thing. If nothing is constant, and in this case, if you talk about the concentration profile, it will be again the similar one, that is C over here. So that will be a dAb by dxA. That is, you need to find out C. That is equal to dz over az. Now over here, z varies from 0 to z. Obviously, the concentration or it varies from xA to xA naught, or if you divide it from xA, the other one, that is dAb to dxA equal to dz over z over the entire length 0 to L, and xA L and xA naught. So it can be written as this thing also. So this is your concentration profile. Similarly, if let's say this is point A, point B, if dAb is constant, that means if dAb is constant, it can be taken out, then it is nothing but concentration into dAb into your xA naught minus xAl over the variable area 0 to L dz over az. And over here, it can be written as xA naught minus xA over xA naught minus xAl equal to dz over az, dz over az 0 to L, 0 to z. That can be written as this thing, if dAb is constant. Third case is, if area is constant, that means it appears to be a rectangular system instead of tapered, then the mass molar transfer rate can be written as A into C into dAb dxA over L, since over the entire length, xAl to xA naught. Over here again, in the very first expression, it is xAl to xA naught. It's clearly over the entire length. So if area is constant, can be taken out. So the molar transfer rate can be expressed as this thing. Similarly, the concentration will be somewhat similar. That is xA naught to xA dAb dx a. That is, in this particular, in the very first case, if area is constant, then what will be? So left hand side will be remain as it is. X a naught dAb dx a equal to, we have z over the entire length f. So if area is constant, temperature is constant. Fourth is a case where, let's consider that both area as well as dAb is constant. Both area and dAb is constant. That is, part B and part C is combined. Then in that case, it will be C dAb, that is x a naught minus x l into area over l, and this thing becomes x a naught minus x a over x a naught minus x l equal to z by. So it becomes this. So these are certain expressions of the modular transfer rate as well as concentration profile for a system. Class hai for a system. That is for a system where, you know, there is a tapered system occurring. Clear? So let's consider. So these are the certain expressions. If nothing is constant, then this will be the expression of molar transfer rate. And similarly, the concentration profile. If dAb is constant, molar transfer rate can be calculated by this expression, and concentration profile will be this thing. Area is constant, this will be the molar transfer rate and correspondingly your concentration profile distribution. And if both area and diffusivity, dAb, that is constant, then you have the expression for your molar transfer rate and your concentration profile. Now let's consider, this was a rectangular system. Now let's consider a cylindrical system, and let's see how these expressions, they are variable in a cylindrical system. So for cylindrical system, what I do is I'll put a line over here, and because I'm not rubbing it, because then we can easily compare the results of both cylindrical and rectangular systems. So let's do it for diffusion through cylindrical systems. Now, through cylindrical systems, let's consider a cylinder in a horizontal position. And let's say this is the center of the axis, center line, and it's a z direction, and this is r direction. So consider one dimension diffusion of species A in a radial direction through a hollow circular pipe with inner and outer radiuses r1 and r2. Okay, so the inner radius is r1 and the outer radius is r2. So let's say this is the shell which we are considering. And across this shell of delta R, there is a diffusion occurring in this given direction. So we know that molar flux in the radial direction will be C dAb as dx a by dr. Now, if you apply the balance over this finite element of thickness delta r, then we have area into NAR, the inlet, minus the outlet. Now, in all the cases, we are assuming that there is no generation, and under steady state, the accumulation part is zero. So we have this thing. So if you divide this entire equation by delta R and take the limit that delta R approaches zero, so we're going to end up as d of dr into a NAR equal to zero. Again, the flux into the area is constant, and flux into area is nothing but your molar transfer rate. Now, notice that the area is perpendicular to the direction of the mass flux, and since there is the area is uniform, so the perpendicular area, which will be 2 pi r, the circumferential area is 2 pi this thing. So if you put all these values over here, that is using this equation 1, 2 and equation 3, so we end up as C DAB C DAB into DXA equal to minus N by A divided by 2 pi L into LNR, where it varies from 0 to X. So this is the expression of your concentration. From here you can calculate your concentration profile, or from here you can calculate your molar transfer rate. Now let's consider the boundary conditions in this particular case. The boundary conditions are at R equal to R1, that is inner, the concentration is XA, XA1, and R equal to R2, its mole fraction, basically XA2. So depending upon the radial position and molar transfer rate, the same thing can be repeated. Now, so we have constants, if any term is constant, we have molar transfer rate, and we have concentration distribution. If nothing is constant, so then this can be integrated to get your NA, that is molar transfer rate. So it will be 2 pi LC DAB into DXA over LN R1 to R2, and where in that case XA1 varies from XA2. That will be molar transfer rate. And then the concentration can be calculated from here, that is XA1 to, no, not XA1, let's keep it as XA, so that we have the expression of R also. So XA to XA1 DAB into DXA, which is equal to LN R by R2 divided by XA1 to XA2 DAB DXA equal to LN R1 to R2. So from here you can get a general expression for the concentration. So this and second is if DAB is constant. If DAB is constant, then this can be integrated and you can get 2 pi LC DAB into XA2 minus XA1 over LN R1 by. So you can clearly get from here. And similarly, from this case also you can get. So you have XA2 minus XA over XA2 minus XA1 equal to LN R by R2 LN R1 by. So this is the case for your cylindrical system. So these are the constants or the expressions of your molar transfer rate and concentration distribution. Now You can clearly see this was a case where, you know, the geometry which is given to us was of a tapered. Now, if had it been a rectangular system, then it would have been very easy, because then in that case, the area is constant. So the things can easily be reduced to, you know, only two terms. Like in this case, the cross-sectional area is kept constant. Now you can have a cylindrical system like in the shape of a cone also. In that case, then the area will be variable. Then you can have another constant over here. That is if the area is constant. Clear? So this is, you can clearly see the difference between rectangular system, the constants for molar transfer rate and concentration profile, and similarly for the cylindrical system also. Now, one more case I want to discuss over here is for your spherical case, spherical systems. That is, we have diffusion in a spherical coordinate system. Now, spherical, when we talk about spherical, the very simplest example can be like a hollow sphere with the inner and the outer radius in R1 and R2 as shown in this figure. Now, suppose it's a hollow sphere. So let's say this is R1. We have the outer sphere. So this is R. So, and let's say this is the shell we are considering over here. Now, this can be explored as a shell of thickness delta R. So we have NAR entering at inlet, and we have NAR at the outlet. Again, the concentration will be the function of the radial direction. The inner radius is R1, the outer radius is R2. So, molar flux is again minus C dAB dxA over dr. Clear? Now, if you consider a spherical differential volume of thickness delta R, spherical differential volume element delta R, the same. So, A into NAR at R, NAR at R plus delta, that is at the inlet and the outlet. Again, no generation, no accumulation. So we have this thing. So if you divide by delta R and take the limit that delta R approaches zero, so again we reduces to the same expression, that is d by dr of A and R is zero. So A into N. Okay, NAR, because we are writing for a species A, so I'm using NA. A as a subscript. NAR is also in the subscript as a constant, which is NA, that is molar transfer rate of component. Now, again, the same thing. Now, since it's a spherical system, so the area is perpendicular area, cross-sectional area will be, let's say, 4 pi, it's 4 pi r squared. So using equation, let's say this is A, B, and C. So using all these equations, A, B, and C, so you can end up as the expression as C dAB dxA equal to NA by 4 pi. So 1 by r squared and dr differential, so it becomes 1 upon r, minus 1 by r, and minus 1 sign was over here. So it is this thing. And you have 0 to 6. Now the boundary conditions over here is that at r equal to xa is xa1, and at r equal to r2, we have x as x equal. Now we can again we can clearly differentiate over here in the case that if we have some constants, we have modular transfer rate, and we have concentration distribution or concentration profile. Now, if nothing is constant, then in that case, the expression becomes 4 pi c integral dAb dxA over 1 by r1 minus 1 by r2, and so it's xA2 to xA1. And the concentration can be dAb dxA over dAb dxA equal to 1 by r minus 1 by r2, 1 by r1, 1 by, so over here it can be written as xA2 to xA1 and xA2 to xA. So it can be this thing. And then if the case is we have dAb as constant, so dAb can be taken out and then it can be simply integrated between xA1 to xA2. So we can write 4 pi c dAb x01 minus x02 1 by r1. This can of dAb can be cancelled out. So xA minus xA2 over xA1 minus xA2 1 by r minus 1 by r2 1 by r1. So these are the expressions of molar transfer rate and your concentration distribution in a case of a spherical system. Now you can clearly see again, it's just purely because of the geometry of the body, the concentration profile and the molar transfer rate, the expressions are different. So in case of rectangular systems, for if the area is constant and diffusivity is constant, then the molar transfer rate is inversely proportional to the length of the geometry. Whereas in this, in the cylindrical system, it's inversely proportional to ratio log of R1 to R2. Whereas in the spherical system, it's inversely proportional to the harmonic difference between the radius R1 and R2. So it is 1 by R1 minus 1 by R2. So these are the different, cases where you can find out the diffusion in a rectangular system, in a cylindrical system, and in a spherical system. Now, let's take one example and where we can see where how these specific geometries are useful to determine the concentration profile or the molar transfer. Now, for this thing, let's take an example. The question is, let's consider a transfer of species A from a spherical droplet or a bubble of radius R to a stationary fluid having a concentration C infinity. That means we are considering a transfer of species A from a spherical drop or a bubble of a radius R to a stationary fluid. That means over here there is a stationary fluid and we have a droplet over here with the radius R. So how the transfer of species A, which is there in the bubble, takes place to this stationary fluid? Now the concentration of A over here is CA infinity. That means it's an infinity pool of concentration A. Determine the concentration distribution of species A within the fluid. How determine the concentration distribution of species A within the fluid? And B is determine the molar rate of species A transferred to the fluid and part C is determine the share wood number. Okay. Now the concentration distribution for a spherical system. Now we have already did that the concentration distribution in a spherical body. Spherical system is Ca minus Ca2 over Ca1 minus Ca2 is equal to one by R minus one by R2 over one by R1 minus one by R2, subject to condition that the diffusivity is constant. Second, steady state is there and no mass, okay, no rest is there, that is no mass transfer affects the radius. So the area is also constant. So this is the concentration distribution. Now since R2 is, R2 in this case is at infinity because what we are considering is basically at R1, we are having the concentration as Ca1 as CaW, that is the fluid. And at R2, which is infinite space, so Ca2 is basically Ca infinite. So this is what we are considering. Since R2 is infinity, so this expression can be reduced to Ca minus Ca2 to Ca1 minus Ca2 equal to R1 by R, or R1 can be simply written as R. So it's R by the radius, simple radius. So R by R. So it is this. Now Ca1 is CaW and Ca2 is infinite. So this can be written as the concentration as Ca minus Ca infinite from Ca at the wall, concentration at the wall is Ca infinite as R by R. So this is the concentration of the part A, that is the concentration of distribution of the species A within the radius of sphere. Now part B is molar transfer rate. So for molar transfer rate, that is Na is 4 pi dAb into R into CaW minus Ca. The molar transfer rate expression we already developed. And now we need to determine the shear wood number. Now this is the molar transfer rate, now which is equal to Na is this. Also Na is A into Na, so which is equal to 4 pi R square into Kc as CaW minus Ca infinity. So if you compare both of them, again, this is the molar transfer rate. Now if you compare both of them again, now what is Kc stands over here? Kc is basically the mass transfer coefficient, which is the convective part because of the motion of the fluid, convective part. So K is the mass transfer coefficient. Now if you compare both the equations, that is A and B. So if you compare both of them, what we get is, we get basically Kc by dAb as 1 by R. So 1 by R is basically D by 2, so it is 2 by D. So from here, so what is shear wood, what is this ratio, that is Kc D by dAb is basically your shear wood number. So which comes out to be 2. So shear wood for a spherical system body is 2. It's the limiting value is 2. So remember this. So if you find any bubble at the surface of a stationary body and the diffusion which is occurring in the sphere, it will have the minimum shear wood number as 2. Yeah. So this is how the diffusion in different geometrical body can be solved, subject to the given condition. If area is constant, if diffusivity is constant, or if nothing is constant, then how those expressions can be used to calculate various other factors. Clear? So that's it with this today's topic on diffusion through different metrical systems. Thank you so much.
Thank you, sir.